We'd like to welcome you from wherever in the world you join us today for this F1 qualifying session here in Shanghai, China.
We are racing!
And as we...
There are a few things that you can still adjust during the session, such as the differential, the brake bias, and the front wing angle, but that's about it. So it's more about optimizing what you do have and adapting your own style to suit the track conditions.
Grid is all set then for the race tomorrow. But before we go, let's quickly remind ourselves of our top three, who are Hamilton, a Haas, and Kimi Raikkonen.
That was so close. Okay now.
I just wanted to pass on the team's expectations for this race. Good luck.
Jesus. Let's go racing!
Title in his rookie year, and it's where Nico Rosberg claimed Mercedes' first win of the modern era in 2012.
Nice.
Shanghai International Circuit then, a 16-corner high-speed thrill ride, the long and ever-tough 2007. Well then, after an exciting qualifying session yesterday, let's take a look at how the cars line up. Lewis Hamilton lines up.
Excellent job yesterday. We qualified above expectations. Let's go out there and put in a performance.
Hamilton on the inside. I am leading the Chinese Grand Prix. How long will this last for? Only time will tell. Trying to hold off. These super fucking soft tires. Breaking zone. Dumped Hamilton the first lap. Managed to hold everybody up there. Time for all this little crap.
That was the fastest lap of the race. Keep this up.
Nice. The RS is now enabled. Down into the pits and rocks and fight all the way back up the field.
get enough time. I won't drop too many places. I think I'll buckle to the boarding places. Ferrari and Mercedes coming to the road. I'm trying to get a Mercedes drive.
Jesus.
Don't turn then. Fucking hell. I've lost a little bit of time there. My left eye is dumb.
Information on Raikkonen. They have some kind of mechanical problem.
That's good.
I'll now get into the pits. On to the fresh tyres. These are the tyres I qualified in, so I'm not too bothered to have done 7 laps on them.
This lap, keep an eye on your distance to the speed limit line as you approach and make sure you don't speed.
Come on, boy. Come on, Jeff. Make sure you do a good fucking pit. Bottas came in earlier, or he's coming in this lap.
Kevin has come into the pits now.
Everyone came in at the right time, I think.
So the gap to our teammate is 7.5 seconds.
Second, that's a win third. Anderson was fucking holding me back a little.
Okay, the gap behind is 8.6 seconds.
Nice. Am I about to whip back this World 3 of the I'm doing. take a right in on the straight. Around it goes the full alley. Getting these fast laps in, and the super soft tail time is so fucking good for the race.
We're fighting here are Vettel and Magnussen. let's make sure we keep managing them properly.
Okay.
There's 3 laps of fuel remaining.
Already 2, Lord.
Seeing any issues with tyre wear right now. You should have good grip for a while yet. Degradation is pretty bad. The grip is going to fall away quickly.
To win in China. Fuck it. After a disappointing 5th place in Australia, I would say. Because we really should have been on the podium there. But off the line, we had contact with Hamilton and Guinea Bottas. Later on in the race, we got brake checks. We didn't have a very good time. Right. final time in the race conditions.
Win.
You're
really
doing
great today. We won! So another fantastic victory for Haas today. Anthony, what do you think made the difference here?
Well, I'd say it's just raw pace, plain and simple. I mean, we could sit here and talk about strategy all day, the overtaking, looking after the tyres, but at the end of it all, if you want to win, you need a package that's got the speed over everyone else, and that's exactly what they had today.
Nice.
Our drivers are making their way out for the podium celebrations, and it's going to be Haas picking up the winner's trophy. Congratulations to the entire team for coming out on top in that amazing Grand Prix.
I won China.
So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. It's okay. A good result for Sebastian Vettel, who moves further ahead at the top of the table. Moving on to the driver of the day then. Anthony Davidson, who would you go for?
Probably Carlos Sainz.
Wow.
You know, strong pace, good work with the strategy,
wow.
Just a very complete drive, I think.
And now let's take a look at the constructors' standings. Ferrari.
That is ridiculous. I should be fucking best driver. I raced a flawless fucking race. I won in a Haas. Done. Simple. Then we're doing very well. Not bad. Finished in China. The next weekend bringing the Bahrain Grand Prix. Interesting.
Hey, good to see you again. The factory sent over the parts that were looking good on the rig. They're being fitted as we speak. Have a look at the report.
Okay. New parts for the chassis, weight reduction. Please show me to power unit for board as well. Nice. turbo. Need replacement. Gearbox. Needs replacement. Things I'm not really interested in. There's lots of practice.
Return to base when you can, so we can go over it. It's tempting to focus entirely on the race, but we should put a bit of time aside to run the qualifying sim program. Try to run it before. Kevin is in. that's an acceptable lap, but you're capable of more if you work at it. Let's get our track acclimatization program complete. It'll help us identify any specific problem areas on the circuit.
Speed.
What? Fuck off.
Let's try for purple. You'll get a bonus for consistency if you can chain good corners together.
I am for the fucking gate though, love. Jesus. Scroll some super softs. I'll count 13 this target time. Three seconds of the book all around.
practice program over. That's all we need for now. Return to the garage pronto.
Would it be 9th in qualifying, apparently?
I don't think so.
This is interesting.
Best lap so far is a 1 minute 37.7.
Let's watch the last 48 seconds, shall we?
An interesting practice session there then. Let's remind ourselves of the top three, who are a Haas, Vettel and Kimi Raikkonen. That concludes an interesting practice session. Let's hope for more excitement as the weekend unfolds.
Nice. So we've got 500 resource points. Okay. Jail man. A good race strategy, but warning, would be flying on the depression.
Okay, super job so far. We're getting great data. Stay focused. There's four laps of fuel remaining. Okay, super job so far. We're getting great data. Stay focused.
Oh.
too bad. Huh?
So far, our fastest lap is a 1:38.2.
Session in front of Hamilton.
As all the cars are now over the line, your top three again are a Haas, Hamilton, and Sebastian Vettel. Practice times are on the board then, but no points are on offer just yet. We'll be back with more F1 action soon.
Which is interesting. I go fucking pole in practice. Shit. I'm tempted a second. So that's good. 80 resource points. I'm demolishing my team, mate. I'm second in the championship. Fuck. Third. Not too bad then. Wait, what? My gearbox ain't gonna fucking cope. Free lots. Gearbox expected. Finish on run 2. Expected to do 6 races. 93 lots, it's 1% water. My gearbox is fault. P3.
At the end of this session, we need to return two sets of tyres. We'll give back the two most worn sets, so we may as well get the most out of them while we can. They won't be available for the rest of the weekend, though, so don't run too hard on anything you might need later on.
Quick look at the classification at the end of the session, then. Here are your top three. Raikkonen.
That's how I look at it. If I don't need to run, I'm not going to.
Letting you know that we've had the team's expectations through for the upcoming qualifying session.
13th or higher would be Magnus. Okay. I'm gonna do that later. I have been streaming for an hour and a half, 25 minutes nearly, and I need something to fucking eat. So I'm gonna get some food, and I'll see you all later.